We start with one hour chart. You want to see how we can look at the chart, whether we can get any trades at top or not. Anyway, if you refer to our analysis, in my last video, since the price was within this move, we mentioned if you get one more drop, then any reversal, we can take the trade. Anyway, there was no trade setup to look for buy. And now we want to see what's the next. And we want to see whether we how we can look at this chart and this correction, okay? Anyway, we start with daily chart. You want to see how we can look at the chart. The only thing is, if we refer to our analysis, I mentioned if we get any correction, daily correction is good for us, because if we get any trade setup from there, we take it. And right now we're looking at this correction. That's mean based on lower time frame, if we get any trade setup, we will take it. And we want to see the breakout of this soon, because we mentioned if the price cannot give us a continuation, we need to be quite careful about this flat for one more drop. And the only reason is, since the if you put our line here, since the price didn't retest or even break the previous low based on daily correction, this is what I'm referring to. But right now, since we have this correction, if we get any trade setup for buy, this is what we're looking for. And if we move to forward chart, the only thing is, we see the price is losing the momentum, but we don't see the divergence. We cannot confirm with the divergence unless we get one move up. Okay, and what I'm looking for, I'm looking for this one as an internal correction in relative to this. That's mean we can expect this one to go as one move up, the price drop, then from there we can look for continuation. Anyway, if we move to lower time frame, it will be more clear. All right, and if you want to look at the chart, what I'm expecting to put this one in relative to this with the internal correction, and this one can turn to flat in relative to this. That means we can expect to get one more drop, and from that, this one turned to a bigger correction for one move up. Okay, that means if you want to put this move in relative to this, this is what we're looking for. Okay, that means we are looking for this one as a flat in relative to this. That means we are looking for one move up, then we can confirm with the internal flat, then we can put this flat in relative to this for one more drop. This is the first things we're looking for. And if the price cannot break the previous top, then we can expect to get one more drop in relative to the first one for continuation. Okay. Anyway, if we get any trade setup for buy from here, we will take the trade. And this is what we're looking for. And since the price almost retest the previous low, having entry above here can be an option, which is somewhere around 0.00287, which is 0.0028. Seven. We can put our entry above here, and what we want to see the continuation as a sharp move. And if the price tag we see is not moving within the first or maximum second hours, we take out the trade. And with the breakout of this top, we see if there is a continue. I mean, is moving as a sharp move is good for us. If it turns to a corrective move, we are not going to keep the trade. And what we're looking for, we want to see whether the price can break 0.003 or not. Because if there is a breakout, it's good for us. But if the price gives us one move up, it cannot break, then we can expect to get one more drop. That's why if we want to look for buy from here, it's a short-term trade, and we want to see the continuation as a short move. With the price tag within the first or maximum second hours, if it is not moving as what we are expecting, we are not going to keep the trade. Anyway, we just follow the chart. If I see any update, I will share. Thanks.